on Time Recruitment. Hope you have a fantastic day wherever you are. Now, graphics. A lot of products are now using touch screens in an embedded environment. Now, what are your options? You can do it yourself, but that can take a long time, and perhaps you have your own libraries. But, you know, you can actually now get libraries, graphics libraries. A company called TouchGFX, I think it's a German company. This is now being vended by ST Micro. They may have even bought this company, but I'm not sure. But anyway, this is a quick demo of one of their products, and this is called TouchGFX Designer. I'm going to show you a quick demo. So you boot it up, it's on Windows, and this one's running on Windows. And you can select here a couple of options. You can go and look at their online applications. If you've got these boards, you can actually go and download these and run them directly on your board. Now, there's a couple of options. You can run it in a simulator, you can run it on your target, or you can generate the code, and you can have a look at the code if you want. So if you have one of these boards, and I'm going to show you this one running in a simulator. I don't have this board, but I'm going to show you the option to actually change that to my application. So if it's my applications, I have this particular board, and I can run up a demo. So if we go in here, select this board now. If you have another board, you can go in here into this library, and you can pick another one of those STM development boards, and you know, anyone that you have or a display that you have, and it will generate the code for that particular display. In my case, it's this one, so we'll select that, and it's the SDM32F429i discovery board. And this demo will run FreeRTOS, so it's going to basically, the underlying software is going to be for FreeRTOS, and then the demo is going to run on top of that. So you can have a blank canvas, or you can use one of these demos and you can manipulate it if you want to. There's quite a number of them here. Some of them will work and some of them will not work for your particular board, so you just got to play around with this and try it and see what happens. So let's just go with a blank one, and the width is 240 by 320. That's the size of that LCD display there. So when we push the button create, it will then compile the packages. Most of it's been already downloaded. If the package is not there, it will actually download the package, and then it will bring up the designer. So you can see it's a blank canvas at the moment. There's nothing on here. You can add all sorts of buttons. There's a buttons here. You can add any of these buttons with a label, buttons with an icon, and so on. You just drag them across like that and drop them in here. And also images. You can stick an image in here. You can stick an animated image in here as well. That will just put a placeholder in, and then you can then upload the image into the placeholder. Containers as well. And it's got progress indicators, shapes, etc., and some miscellaneous stuff out here, analog clock, digital clock. So if we just put an image in here, we just drop it in here, you can then center that image, and then you can go in here and you can go and select where you want the image to go. So in here you have to push the button, this one here. So I prepared that one, and we'll just open it, and we'll load it in. There it is. Okay, and then we just basically move it along. So we can just move it there. So we'll put it in the center here. It's centered. So we want to actually now generate code for this image. Now, this is a very, very simple demo. So it's just going to show you this image on the display. So you can run it in the simulator. We won't do that now. We'll run it on the target. So we clicked that, and it will then compile the code for that. It takes a little bit of a while, so we'll just wait. And we'll come back. There you go. It's done it. Well, now let me show you a little bit more sophisticated application. So we look at these download ones. Let's look at this one here. This is a very interesting demo. It's supposed to run on this board. I don't have this particular board, but we will run it in the simulator, and I can show you how powerful this particular development environment is. This will generate all of the code automatically for you to run on your target. And there you have it. So this is the application here. It's a fairly complex demo. So if we click in here, you got the kitchen and the bathroom. So if you got a kitchen, it's actually very nicely done. If you click on some of these devices like this one, the oven, you can turn it on and start it, and you can see you can change the fan, and it's quite a nice elegant design for the oven. That's the temperature, so you can set the temperature, you can look at the devices, and you can set the temperature in different rooms. You can even look at recipes if you wanted to. So for this one here, you can play a video. It actually has a video built in here. You can personalize it. That's not working. Devices, temperature, and so on. So you go to the kitchen. Let's see if there's anything else here. Oh, okay, you got the fan. So you can turn it on. Turn the light on. You can change the fan speed, and so on. So it's pretty cool. I mean, the graphics are very good. You can go to the bathroom. Same sort of thing. You got the washer there. You can control the washing machine, the cycles, etc. You can set a timer on it as well. You can set the speed You can turn on the bath. You can set the temperature for the bath, jet controls, how you want it to be, lighting, and then power. This is a very, very sophisticated GUI. It's very well designed. But anyway, this is an example of what you can do with these libraries. So if you guys want to play around with it, you can download it from the STM website. Just type in TouchGFX. And you'll see the application. You can download it and play around with it. Now, I want to show you something else as well. There is another company called TARA Systems, and they do this Embedded Wizard, which is a GUI development environment, and you can actually design your application. Now, I'm going to show you a demo. You download the particular package for your development board. In my case, it's the STM32F429 Discovery. Downloaded it. I've gone into that directory. I've gone to the project, and I'm going to run a batch file, and this is the batch file called Flashmaster Demo. And in the directory structure for this, when you install it on your computer, you will find a directory called Master Demo, and in that there will be a bat file which will actually flash the demo onto the board. So we'll run it now, and it's just called flashmasterdemo.bat. So when we run that, it will talk through the STM link and it will download and flash the memory, and you'll see it come up on the board. Now it's programming the memory. As you can see, it's flashing the actual program onto the board, and then it will run it, and you'll see it come up in a minute. So have a play with that as well and see what you think. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments field. Have you developed your own GUI? Are you building out these quite complex GUI displays now that are required on all sorts of devices now? There's lots of applications that are now requiring GUI, and there you have it. Now it's showing you on the actual board. It's running there, and you can click. Let's say this one here, and you can go back to home. You can run up a graphics accelerator. There's testing the graphics on here, showing you the CPU load. This frames, it's 63 frames per second, which is pretty good for this board. The accelerator is on, and if we go to scenario, it'll actually just do these bitmaps for your rectangular fill. And you got the climate as well. So if you click and start, shows you the temperature, current temperature, remaining time. You can stop it if you wanted to. And it can show you the humidity, temperature, etc. So there you have it. So it's running on the target. Very interesting library, worth checking out. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments field, and let me know if you're using these libraries or you're developing something with these libraries, or if you've got some other libraries that you've found or you're using that you built yourself, or there's some open source stuff. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments field, and see you in the next one. Cheers.